Frazier.
Ali's all business in there now.
Down goes Shaver. The fight is over.
Madison Square Garden, the most famous punch bowl in boxing history. And if these walls could talk, they'd tell you about the golden age of the heavyweights, late 60s, early 70s, with names like Muhammad Ali, Joe Frazier, George Foreman, Ken Norton, Ernie Shavers, Jimmy Ellis, Matt Foster, Oscar Bonavena, George Schiavello, all fought here. And one of the most popular of all, a perennial garden favorite who fought in this very ring several times, Jerry Quarry.
Spanning the globe to bring you the constant variety of sport.
Jerry Quarry's career was a checkerboard career. It wasn't singular. It wasn't as if it was one end to another. It started out brilliantly. As an amateur, he was 170-13. He goes to the 1965 Golden Gloves Finals, heavyweight, and wins 5 out of 5 all by knockout, a record never to be broken. Turns pro the same year. Not his decision, his father Jack's. They basically wanted him as a pro to make money. He didn't want to wait for the 68 Olympics. Wanted money now. 1966, next year, 20 fights, undefeated, goes in against Eddie Machen. Wrong fight. Fights wrong fight, undertrained, loses for the first time. Quarry is down, but he's not down forever. By 1967, he's come back. The WBA has stripped Muhammad Ali of his championship. They're having an elimination contest. Quarry fights Floyd Patterson twice.
But he does not follow.
First fight in the elimination contest is a draw, albeit Quarry has knocked down Patterson twice.
Is on his feet for second round at the Coliseum. 20,000 plus watching. A left hook sent him down first, and then a right hand, and he's hanging on for dear life.
Rematch, second fight. Quarry knocks Patterson down twice again. This time he gets a decision.
Oh! Just as in the first fight, the second round, the chopping right. First the left and then the chopping right. Patterson swinging back and down goes Patterson again from the short right. The second.
And by 1967, he is dissecting people like Tad Spencer, number one rated contender.
I'm the next heavyweight champion of the world. There's no doubt in my mind, should be in Jerry Quarry's, nobody else's mind. I'm the baddest man tonight. Jerry Quarry cannot box with me. I'm a superior boxer.
I think Tad's trying to prove a point to himself, not me, because I'm not listening to what he's got to say.
He is stunned. He is a punching bag for Quarry at this moment.
By the end of the next year, 68, he's fighting Jimmy Ellis for the WBA vacant heavyweight championship with a broken back that he got in a bar fight at his father's bar, the neutral corner.
Well, I thought Jerry Quarry was a good fighter, you know. He said that he could beat a lot of guys. Jerry Quarry, he can punch. I'll give him credit now. He did hit me a couple of good shots. And he did hurt me a couple of good times. So I started backing up. When he started calling me, that's when I really unloaded. Back up, uppercut, I'm going to lean back in there. Hoof. I had a lot of confidence in myself because I used to be Ali's sparring partner. And when I know when I can give him a trouble and give him a hard time, I'm going to give the other guy a whole lot of trouble. So that's where I felt when I fought Jerry Quarry, that he just couldn't beat me because I wasn't going to let him beat me.
He loses a decision. Jerry Quarry, true to his meaning as a real warrior and a proud warrior, says, had they given me the decision, I would have given the belt back. And now by 1969, he beats a number one ranked contender right here again, Madison Square Garden Buster Mathis. He gets a fight with Joe Frazier for the New York State Athletic Commission's heavyweight championship. The first round is un-be-effing-leavable.
Quarry punching, go against the ropes. A lot of punches thrown in this first round. A good left by Frazier and a good counter punch right by Quarry.
The two warriors go head-to-head like two bull moose in heat. It's punch to punch, slugger to slugger. The crowd is on its feet. This is the greatest round of boxing we have ever seen.
30 seconds left in the first round. The two men trading punches throughout the round. Good left by Quarry.
Jerry was a tough guy. Jerry come to fight.
Now, Frazier is pummeling Quarry with lefts and rights.
And if Jerry didn't have a softer skin, I think Jerry would be champion of the world, because most of the time, Jerry will stop on a cut.
Unfortunately for Jerry, and they stopped the fight in the seventh round. First time a fight of Quarry's has been stopped on a cut, which is meaningful, because there'll be more. And after Joe Frazier fights George Chavallo. George Chavallo's greatest punch was a left jaw to the right glove.
As far as getting a title shot was concerned, he still had to beat me, I think, to get a title shot. He had to earn his way back in to get a title shot. It was a very tough fight. I think I got off to an early start, then he started to come on, and then my eye gave me a little trouble. My eye ballooned. And actually, by the end of the fifth round, my eye was like, it looked like a half a grapefruit had been slapped onto my eye. Fortunately, the fight went on. I started to shoe shine, and it started to come up to the head. Left, right, and the last right, really, I rocked Jerry. And I beat him to the punch of the left hook, and I hit him high on the head, right about here, just at the temple.
And Quarry is down. Quarry taking the mandatory 8 count. 10 seconds to go in round 7. Oh, no. Oh, no.
He misread the count. He's knocked out. We don't know what happened, but whatever it was strange with a capital S. He's now lost to George Chavallo. Of all the people you don't lose to. He is the gatekeeper to the heavyweight crown. He's lost to George Chavallo. But by 1970, he comes back in the same ring, and he fights the number one rated contender again. All knockouts, all wins, a man named Max Foster. And he stops him in 6, right here in this ring.
Cut around the right eye. Congratulations on, I think, a superb victory over a fine fighter, Matt Foster. And I want to know how you feel.
I'm a little tired, but he can punch like heck, man.
I'll bet he can.
That begets him in 1970, because he's the only one of the top 10 rated heavyweights to offer up to fight a comebacking Muhammad Ali in Atlanta. Quarry had problems up to that fight. He was threatened. He was shot at. A white man is fighting a black man in Atlanta, Georgia. The black man failed to step forward for the draft, but Quarry took the fight.
Ali's ripping left jab opens a cut over Quarry's left eye, and Quarry comes right back.
And by the third round, after carrying the second round with punches to the body, he's cut. You can see the bone. Teddy Benton, his trainer, stops the fight. The cut has stolen Jerry Quarry's potential to beat Muhammad Ali. And once again, he's down. How many times can this man go down and come back? But he ain't down. I'm 71. The indomitable, the indestructible, the unsinkable. Jerry Quarry is sent over to England as another sacrificial lamb. That seems to be his position, his place, his point. He's going to fight the British heavyweight champion, and in 63 seconds knocked him out. By 1972, he's risen to the top of the heavyweight elite class, a great class indeed, and he's fighting Muhammad Ali a second time, this time in Stateline, Nevada.